my lovelies, and welcome back to my channel. I'd just like to give a big shout out to all my returning subscribers and all my new subscribers as well. I really appreciate all of you for supporting the channel and helping it grow. I love having you guys. So anyway, we're going to be doing pick a pile today. It is a message from a passed over loved one, deceased loved one I usually call it, but so we're just going to see what they need to say to you, whether there's anything they want to tell you that's coming, and we'll just go from there. So this is a general collective reading. Take what resonates, leave what doesn't, and if it's not your pile, choose another pile. Okay, so yeah, I'll see you at your piles. So pile one, let's get started. So we have a postcard from your spirit guides as well as your passed over loved ones. So I'm going to leave that till the end. Okay, that's your postcard from them. And I'm going to start with these ones first. We've got, we are so connected. And we have, I have become one with your guides. Oh, that's interesting. Okay, let me lay them down first. I like this. Oh, excuse me. Sorry, I'm drinking a fizzy drink and now I've got the burps. So, yeah. Anyway, let me lay him down first. And then you've got, my death was painless. Please don't worry or hold on to guilt. So that's your message there from passed over loved one. And then we've got some angel messages as well from your angels as well as your passed over loved one. We are easing the blockage which is holding you back. Go for it. Then we've got, listen to your inner voice as we try to guide you. Use your intuition. Changes can bring you a new life and energy. We will hold your hand. Got tarot cards there, but I want to do these first. So you've got Archangel Uriel. Your emotions are healing, which enables you to open the greater love. I will help you release anger and unforgiveness from your heart and mind. And Seraphina, I am an angel of families. A happy change or addition is coming to your family. Okay. And right, before I lay down the tarot cards, from what I'm seeing from the message from your deceased loved one and your angels here, is whoever passed away here, hopefully we can get to the bottom of who it is, has now become either your spirit guide as well, or they work with your spirit guide to help you. Now, what I'm picking up here is from this passed over loved one, is that there's a lot of resentment, maybe hurt, maybe pain, unresolved pain. It could have been that you may not have had a chance to talk to this person and express how certain things in your life may have upset you. You know, it could have been you had a turbulent relationship with this person. So you're holding on to all this resentment and emotions and anger, okay? So what this person is saying, as well as your angel, is that that anger needs to be released. It could even be in your everyday life is what's going on with you. Maybe that's why you've got all your angels and your this passed over loved one with you, trying to help you. And it could be this passed over loved one is communicating with your spirit guides to give you that little bit more help. Now, this is lovely, because if for some of you, you are expecting, or maybe you don't know you're expecting, but what this person in spirit is saying is there is a new addition coming to the family. Now, if you look at this hand here, that's an adult hand holding a child's hand. So it could be, you know, this person's in spirit with your unborn child at the moment. They're both waiting. So it could be that this person's actually looking after your child and protecting them till they're ready to be born. Now, this energy here that's coming through is saying that you're ignoring your intuition. There could be signs that you're being given. Your intuition is telling you something, and it could be that you're just not, you're not listening, you're not hearing. It could be that you've got a blockage. So they want you to listen to this, okay? Yeah, because look, exactly what I just said. They're easing away for a blockage. Something's holding you back from something. You've got a block. and listen to your intuition, okay, guys? So let's look at your tarot cards, the pile ones. We've got the Chariot, we've got Justice, Libra, Cancer, and Taurus. Libra, Cancer, Taurus. So the cards, on the cards, they say, rewards that comes from hard work, successfully balancing many priorities at once, determination and willpower, public recognition, okay? Justice is be impartial to objectives, stand up for what you believe, try to see all the sides of a situation. You will win if your position is one of integrity, okay? And then we've got the Hermit. Time spent in peaceful meditation and meaningful solitude. Shine your light as an example to others. Seek out or become a spiritual mentor, self-discovery. Now, with these three cards here, you could have something going on in your life here, is what this spirit is saying, that, you know, maybe you don't defend yourself, but they want you to start defending yourself and sticking up for yourself. Stick up for what you believe in. Don't shy away from it. Don't be scared to, you know, communicate what you want to say to people. For some of you, with this hard work here, it could be maybe some of you have had a lot of heartbreak when it comes to maybe trying to conceive or have a child. Maybe things have not gone well. Maybe that's what this spirit's trying to say, that something really good is happening here. But I need more information in regards to this. Okay, let's use these. Right, hang on. So, spirit, angels, ancestors, please tap me into this spirit in heaven. What would they like to tell my pile ones? Knight of Pentacles. It's got Earth sign here. Tell me more about this Knight of Pentacles here. Pentacles, Four of Pentacles, Five of Pentacles, bloody hell, Queen of Pentacles, Temperance, the Devil, the Tower, the Lovers. Okay, bear with me, guys. Right. This person that's coming through from the spirit world is a Knight of Pentacles, okay? But it also, they also could be a Queen of Pentacles. So don't forget, these are energies as well. So they can be male or female. So this is someone that, you know, could have been a business owner, could have done really well for themselves financially, okay? They were very giving. This could be someone's husband, and they're a father, they're committed, okay? So this is someone that takes commitment quite seriously. But what I'm getting from this, these surrounding cards, it could have been that this person, there may have been troubles before they passed. Okay, I think I'm seeing what's going on here. Now, I feel like this person didn't give, whoever this is for, pile one, this person didn't give you a commitment that you wanted. Okay, I feel like they were a bit slow in making up their mind. There was a lot of back and forth. There was a lot of I don't know. You know, they took too long to decide whether they wanted to be with you, whether they wanted to commit to you. Okay, now with the Five of Pentacles, it speaks of someone that is either cold, that turns cold, or there's coldness between two people, or this person was struggling a lot. They could have been going through some kind of poverty, a sickness, you know, an illness here. Yeah, I feel like they went through an illness here. Definitely something to do with a long-term illness is what I'm picking up here. I'm getting quite emotional. I don't know what I'm picking up, your energy. Yeah, this was a long-term illness. And, you know, the reason why I'm saying it was a long-term illness, if you look at the Knight of Pentacles and you look at the Four of Pentacles, okay, Knight of Pentacles is long-term and it's slow. So it's slow to take effect on people, you know, or the Knight of Pentacles is someone that's slow moving energy, but it was slow to happen, but it dragged on for a long time. Now the Four of Pentacles is not wanting to let go. That's why I'm seeing this was an illness that just they could not get rid of, okay? And with the Five of Pentacles is illness, sickness, you know, that kind of thing. And they were a Queen of Pentacles here. This is Taurus, Virgo, Capricorn energy we've got here. We've got Sagittarius energy as well. We've got Capricorn energy. Oh, God. And we've got Gemini energy here as well. Now, with the Temperance here, this is all about inner peace and harmony. It's like trying to, you know, find balance within oneself. But they couldn't. There was no finding a balance for whatever illness they had here. They just couldn't find like a cure. So with the Devil and the Tower, so the Devil is toxic behaviors, you know, addictions. So this could have been an addiction for somebody that may have ended up losing their life. I'm trying to be as sensitive as I can here. So yeah, it could have been some kind of addiction here that ended up being a long-term addiction that they couldn't get over it. They did try, but they kept falling back on it. Okay, they couldn't get out of this addiction. It could even be like an illness, you know, certain illnesses here that, seeing as it being the Devil, it's like it's an evil illness. I don't really want to say it over YouTube, but I think you know where I'm going with that, you know, the big C. So yeah, and this with the Tower, I feel like it was so unexpected for them. For some of you, if this is someone that was addicted to something and they passed away because of addictions, this happened suddenly, and what they're saying in spirit is they just didn't expect it. They didn't see it coming. Okay, it happened so suddenly. And with the, if it's the other way for some of you, once again, it literally rocked their whole foundation. It caused a lot of, you know, mental chaos. It caused a lot of problems. They may have even become a bit addicted, a bit aggressive, maybe their personality changed a bit. So what I'm getting here, this, I do feel like this is somebody that you were connected to romantically, okay? You know, I'm going to clarify the lovers. And like I said, I do feel like you may have wanted more with this person, but there was a um and an ah, and there was a backwards and forth, you know. Let's have a look. And this is why I feel like this message here about that anger, you know, the anger and the hurt and everything, you're holding on to this, and this person in spirit wants to tell you, you need to let go of this anger and hurt, okay? So tell me about the lovers here. Tell me about the lovers. Please, can we stop giving me so many cards, Spirit? Can I just have a couple? Tell me about the lovers. Something ended between you two here. I mean, it could be because the person passed away with death. You know, I don't really like to, you know, to go that deep with that kind of thing. Okay. So yeah, with the lovers here, this relationship wounded you very deeply, and you're still carrying the scars around today. Okay, you still have got a wall up. You know, maybe you've just not communicated to anybody about how you feel about losing this person and what happened leading up to it, you know. So you're holding this resentment in, okay? And the thing is, what this person in spirit wants to say is that, you know they hurt you, they know they wounded you, but you've got to let it go. So, what else would this person in spirit like to tell my pile ones? What else would they like to tell them? Actually, hang on a minute, guys. Spirit, tell me about this Seraphina, please. Tell me about this Seraphina that keeps looking at me, and I need to clarify it before I ask what else they want to say. Tell me about Seraphina here, please. Oh, I might have to change these cards. Just want to choose me off. Maybe they don't want to say. Tell me more about Seraphina. Yeah, like I said earlier, I feel like you guys may have been having problems conceiving. I'm not a doctor, I'm just, you know. I feel like you've had problems for a long time, and this person in spirit's telling you, you know, here, what it's saying is, I am an angel of family. It's a happy change or addition is coming to your family. So it may not even be pregnancy. It just may mean that something very happy is going to happen. There's some kind of happy change here. So for some of you, it can be a new, you know, a pregnancy. Some of you could just be a new, I don't know, a new fresh start. But it's something that you've been wanting for a very long time. And it's like emotionally drained you. You know, this thing that you want. Five of Wands, Nine of Swords, Knight of Swords, and the Eight of Wands. Okay, so yeah, with the Five of Wands, this is, you know, it could have been family clashes, it could have been arguments within the family, it could be, you know, I feel like this is more you guys, though. You beat yourselves up about, you know, if you are wanting a baby, you know, and things are not going well, I feel like you blame yourself. This is what I'm getting from the Five of Wands and this energy here. This person in spirit is asking you, please do stop blaming yourself, okay? They're saying here, you know, this is causing you a lot of sleepless nights and worries here. You know, this is depression. It can be, you know, it's grief. And they want you, you know, they're worried about you here. I feel this is why they're working with your spirit guides here, to try and help you with this turmoil that you're going through. Now, the Knight of Swords talks about big change, okay? Something that is going to come about, that's going to bring about big change. you know, this is a change in lifestyle, a change in the situation here, if it is to do with wanting a child here. So yes, a big change is on its way to you, okay? And we've got Gemini, Libra, Aquarius here. And Eight of Wands is something, because these two cards together, this is swiftness. This is something, this is action. This is coming towards you very quickly, very unexpectedly here with the Eight of Wands. Okay, so it can be news that you're waiting for or something that's going to happen very quickly. Now, the truth will be revealed to you, okay? So it's truth and clarity. It's some kind of news, message, communication here, okay? And what I'm saying is the truth with the Ace of Swords, as well as what Spirit says. So let's see what else this energy wants to say to you. What else would you like to tell my pile ones? We've got Queen of Swords, Six of Swords, Two of Wands, and Judgment. Right. And the Three of Cups. Yes, look. This is lovely. So what this spirit wants to say to you, there's some celebrations coming up here. So you could be celebrating an anniversary, a wedding, a christening, you know, it's celebrations with people that you love, people that you care about. Or it could be celebrating some kind of news that you're going to be receiving. Like I said, there is some kind of news coming towards you. This is, you know, with the Six of Cups, it can speak of reconciliation. You know, this can be receiving gifts, it can be reminiscing with other people. So if it's a get together or celebrating, it could be that you guys are going to be reminiscing about maybe the past, or, you know, maybe talking about this person here. But this person in spirit saying there's a celebration coming towards you, okay? Some kind of happiness that's going to be happening. Now with the Queen of Swords here, this person in spirit is saying that you've got your walls up, you've got your guards up. Yes, you've been deeply hurt. But it's like that card that I read out earlier about using your intelligence, using the, you know, stand up for what you believe in. You've got the skills to actually deal with certain people in certain situations, because the Queen of Swords is very, very intelligent when it comes to that. She can see through, you know, anybody, you know, if they try to pull the wall over her eyes, the Queen of Swords, she'll see through it. Okay. You know, that this person in spirit saying that they know you're carrying a lot of repressed pain, they know you're carrying around a lot of sadness, but they really would like you to let it go with the Six of Swords. Six of Swords is let it go, leave it behind and move into calmer waters. This is what spirit, this person in spirit is saying. When with the Two of Wands, they're saying to you, this is a decision that you need to make for yourself. Only you can decide. They're trying to give you this little bit of push, you know, but you've got to decide for yourself whether you can leave this behind. But they're saying you can. Now, I've got Judgment here. Yeah, this is all about, you know, make this decision, stick with it. It's a clarity that's coming to you. Maybe seeing this reading, it's some kind of clarity, you know. And it's like a wake-up call as well. I just feel like this person's spirit is just wanting to shake you and say, just wake up, come on, you know. So, any more you want to say to my pile ones? Okay then. Seven of Swords, Eight of Swords, Knight of Cups, Knight of Wands. And the Star, fire sign, Leo, Aries, Sagittarius. We've got Aquarius, got quite strong air sign in this reading. So this person in spirit, what they want to say to you is that you're literally burying, you're running away from your problems, you're not facing the hurt, you're not facing the pain. And this is affecting your mental health here is what they're saying, okay? You feel like you're just like in a mental prison, you feel like you can't get out of it. How do you get out of it? How do I stop these thoughts? you know, but what this person in spirit is saying, it's all self-imposed. It's like some, it's you doing it to yourself. There is a way out of it. You are not trapped. You can, you know, face what it is that you're going through. They want you to start, you know, embracing life again, you know, finding, because with the Queen of Swords, she's very cold, okay, she's very detached, and they feel like this is how you've become. You know, we had the Nine of Wands as well, is where the wall is up with you guys. So it's like you're not letting anybody in, and they want you to go back to the way you used to be, this person that was very, you know, charming, romantic, very loving, very caring, you know, and, you know, and they want you to find that passion again that you used to have for life. But it's not there, because this is, you're trapped in a mental prison here, okay? And they don't want you to do that. They want you to go after your dreams. They're saying to you that, you know, sky's the limit, basically, with the star. They're saying, you know, there's miracles coming towards you. There's hope. There's hope here. You just got to take the blindfold off with the Two of Swords and see the bigger picture. See what's around you. Okay, let's get your postcard, pile one. Actually, wait. Right, what advice would you give the pile ones? Empress. Oh, Three of Cups again. I feel like, okay, this is for some of you, okay? Six of Cups again, guys. You're going to be celebrating something so wonderful here, is what this advice is coming through here. Now, the Empress is pregnancy, or expectant mum, expectant father. This is the Divine Feminine, okay? They know you've been through a lot. You've experienced a lot of hardships. But, you know, things are going to start smoothing out soon for you. Things are going to start looking up. You're going to go through a very happy period in your life. We've got the Three of Cups again. You're going to be celebrating something here. Something wonderful. Something that's taken a very long time for you to achieve this. Something you've been wanting for so long here, is what they're saying. So there is the advice to you, is what they're giving you. It's around the corner, you know. Don't let these negative thoughts, you know, affect you. So let's get your postcard from this person. So we've got, dearest you, miracles never run out. Look back over your life and you will see so many moments of synchronicity. When all the right people and the right place, the right opportunities and the right time just showed up without any of your help. Think back to how you felt just before a miracle happened. See, now look at this, guys. Now, I don't look at these cards. They're talking about miracles. They're talking about synchronicity here. When I said at the beginning, I'm getting very passionate. I feel like this energy is like just wanting to, like I said, they want to shake you. That's what I'm getting. Look at the synchronicities, look at the signs from the universe, look at the signs from your spirit guides. There's things that you're missing. Your intuition is closed off because you're in your head about everything. Now, they're talking about miracles in this postcard as well. So a miracle is going to happen. Okay, so think back to how you felt just before a miracle happened. You felt you were giving up. There we go. But it was more like a gentle surrender to whatever was about to happen. We want you to know that miracles are being concocted for you, and you will never, ever run out of them. That's the star. You just don't get to choose how they come, who will deliver them, when they will show up, and what they will do for you. All of that is our department. Spirit knows what is best for you and what wants to be expressed through you. You are incredible and amazing and a magnet for miracles. That would be a good mantra for you today. We're on it. For fuck's sake. We're on it. Relax. If only you knew how much you were loved. Sigh. Aww. So your mantra for today is what they're saying is, what's it here? You are incredible and amazing and a magnet for miracles. Maybe use that phrase, guys, okay? There's some kind of lovely thing that's about to happen to you here, and they just want you to... I feel like this energy here in spirit is very worried about you. and your mental health. I mean, I'm not a doctor, but this is what the cards are saying, okay? So yeah, I'm gonna leave it there, my lovelies. I hope this resonated for you. If it did, please hit like. If you want to comment and tell me about, you know how this affected you or your experiences, I'd love to hear from you, okay? You take care, bye. Hey, pile two, so if you chose this pile, this is your reading. We have a postcard for you from your loved one and from spirit. So let's get started, my pile two. So we've got, although you may not understand it now, everything happens for a reason. These are your messages here. It's not your fault. Remember me by the happy memories we created. Oh, guys. Okay, right. Now we have Francesca. What do you desire right now? Visualize it and it will come about. Negativity will block your progress. We've got Daniel. I am the angel of marriage and I'm assisting you right now. Okay, so you're picking up strong relationship vibe here, even marriage, because we've got the memories here. Yeah. Okay, and then we've got focus your mind on what you really want. We are helping. Problems that have held you back are being cleared. We are monitoring it. And your tarot cards are number eight of swords, mental health card. The illusion of entrapment, a lack of self-confidence that makes you feel helpless, being afraid to take action, take responsibility for your life now. Then we have the world. Brilliant success, a time for joyful accomplishment and spiritual enlightenment, freedom to do whatever you want, be proud of yourself. And then we have number three, which is death. Great sadness that will heal with time, let go of the past, personal growth that comes from challenges, healing misunderstandings, being there for those in need. Oh God, these readings, that's why I only do them, I think, once a month or just every 6 weeks or whatever, because they really do affect me quite badly. I've done pile one, but your readings like literally just really affected me. But anyway, a lot of sadness here. That's what I mean by affected me. So I do feel like this was your spouse, my pile twos. I feel like even if you weren't married, this was your long-term partner. There's a lot of questions of how did it happen? Maybe you didn't notice this person was ill. Maybe they decided to ignore the fact that there was a problem, you know, and you blame yourself because you didn't force them to go and see a doctor or go to the hospital. You know, that's what I'm picking up here. But this is why this person in spirit is saying to you, it is not your fault. And they don't want you. You've got a lot. I've even got goosebumps. You've even got a lot of, oh, my whole body's gone cold. Oh, okay. This energy is really coming through. Oh, bear with me a minute, guys. Wow. So they do not want you to sit there in grief. They want you to look at the happy memories that you both had together. Maybe you've not wanted to look at any photographs or any videos that you may have done together because it's too painful, but they want you to start doing that because I feel like that is the healing process for you. Okay, remember the good times together. Now, you're surrounded in negativity at the moment with the Eight of Swords as well. You're in this mental prison. You feel trapped. You feel like you can't get out of this depression, this sadness. It could be that you're afraid for your future as well, that you don't know, you know, how you're going to maybe cope on your own. This person could have been your rock in life. You know, these two cards here are very sad because you've got the world, which this is an ending, this is a chapter that's closed in your life, there's no way of going back, obviously not, you know, you've got the death with the card as well, you know, and it's saying great sadness that will heal. And this is what this person's saying, yes, you are dealing with a lot of sadness at the moment, but you will heal, and you know, you will let go of the past. And I feel like for some of you, Pile 2, this is very fresh. This is not something that happened a while ago. This is very, very fresh. Yeah, and I know it's really horrible to lose a loved one, especially when it's unexpected as well. Yep. Very sad. Anyway. So Spirit, what more does this energy want to tell my Pile 2s? What more would you like to tell my Pile 2s? The very lovely energy this is. I'm feeling a very, I feel like this is like a King of Cups kind of energy, guys. You know, don't forget, it can be male and female as well, because these are energies. Someone that is, it's got such a sympathetic nature towards people, you know, very compassionate and calm. I don't feel like they lost their temper much. Swords, Ace of Swords on the back of the deck, and the Tenet. Yeah, this is someone that you built a life with. Gemini, Libra, Aquarius. Got the overall energy is the Ace of Swords. You know, yeah, King of Swords is someone that was very, like I just said, very calm-minded. They didn't get emotional about anything, you know. They didn't really blow up and get emotional, and you know those kind of people that do that. They get too emotional, and then things get out of hand when you're getting in an argument and things like that. I think I'm more of the King of Swords. I'm just, unless I'm pushed, and that's what I'm picking up with this energy, unless they were pushed to that limit, then they would explode. But the King of Swords is somebody that is very, it was very intelligent. They could have actually had a very high up job, you know. They could have been a manager of a company, they could have been a CEO, you know, that kind of person is what I'm picking up. This was someone that had morals, that had integrity. They were very honest. They would look at things in a very practical way as well, you know. Like I said, not emotional. They may have been distant at times. They may have been a bit cold, you know. They didn't show them. I think this person had problems with showing their, showing affection or love, you know. It wasn't that they didn't love you. They just wasn't really open with it. Maybe not with everybody. They were with you, but not with certain people. So that's the energy that I'm picking up here. Now, this I do believe is someone's spouse here, spouse, wife, husband, whatever, because of the Ten of Pentacles. This is someone that you married or was in a serious commitment, and you built a life together, so you could have had children with this person. So yeah, you built this long-term commitment with one another. And I feel like this person's left a legacy behind. I feel like that whatever he was doing, he or she was doing, this legacy is now being left to you, and it can be passed on to your children and their children, okay? So, you know, this person done very well for themselves. Now, with the Ace of Swords here, this is like truth and clarity, or it's the tarot reader saying, you know, what I'm saying is the truth. So, anyway. And, you know, with the Sun as well, this energy wants to say to you that the time they had with you was very, very happy for them. You brought them a lot of fun, laughter. You brought a lot of positivity into their life. It was a happy, happy connection here. Oh, hang on. We've got a sneaky few cards that turn over at the back there that I didn't see. Hang on, let's have a look. Page of Wands, King of Pentacles, King of Cups. What did I say? King of Cups, Spirit. This Right, look, this is the same energy here, guys, okay? I think depending on what mood or what situation this energy like was in with people, that's the person you would get, okay? But with you, you got it all. So you have someone's husband here, someone's spouse, someone that was a business owner, and that's exactly like the King of Swords. So we've got Taurus, Virgo, Capricorn, Cancer, Scorpio, Pisces energy as well here. So yeah, you had someone that was there for their family, that was very loyal, you know, faithful, looked after the family, you know, wanted to take care of the family, you know, and this is someone that brought a lot of happiness into the connection. And then you've got the King of Cups, is what I said. It's about someone that is, you know, emotionally mature, emotionally available. They were very balanced. So yeah, I feel like you got a very good person here. This person was very passionate about you. It's like, I don't know. And I feel like for you as well, it was like you didn't know. Maybe you didn't know how passionate they were about you. But they were very passionate about you. And we've got the Sun again on the back of the deck. I mean, freaking hell. So, one more. Would you like? I'm not even saying anything here. Ten of Cups. Yeah, look at this. Seven of Pentacles. Death. Again, you've got Death twice. So, yeah, you built a life together. You built a family and a home together. You know, two people that committed to one another, you know, marriage. You brought a lot of fulfillment. It was a, you know, this is a happily ever after card. So this is what that he or she is saying to you, that you were there happily ever after. Okay. And with the Seven of Pentacles and the Death here, it could be that, you know, bear with me a minute, guys. Seven of Pentacles. Okay. That's one. Yeah. Okay. What this energy is saying here is that you need to start building again. And you've had that in a few cards. You need to start living again. You need to start building a life for yourself again. They are here to encourage you, your angels and your ancestors, as well as this person in spirit. Okay. You need to, with the Death, it is transitioning. You need to find a way to transition into maybe, you know, being on your own. And you can build again. You can do it all on your own. You've got, you know, you're that type of person, is what they're saying. So what else would you like to tell our pile twos? Well, there you go, the Fool. Oh, Fool, the Hermit, the Tower, the Nine of Pentacles, Six of Wands. Okay, I love this energy. Whoever this is a beautiful energy. Absolutely love it. Okay. So, you know, what else I want to tell you is with the Tower, you know, this was sudden. This was something just so unexpected that you both were not expecting it, okay? And your whole world got turned upside down, you know, it has. Everything that you built up, the Ten of Pentacles, the Ten of Cups here, it fell apart, you know, because of losing this person that you love. You are single. They're telling you you're doing very well financially. Yeah, you may be missing the Ten of Pentacles, which is love, which is this energy here. You are missing them so much, but and they know this. And with the Six of Wands, this is victory and success. This is what they're saying to you is that you've got this beautiful future ahead of you. Okay, you've got this brand new beginning. You need to start again. Just take that leap of faith. Don't worry, they're there with you. You've got happiness and success in your future, but what you're doing is you know, for some of you, it could have been quite a while that this happened. For some of you, maybe not. But you're hiding away. You're not putting yourself out there when you, you should be putting yourself out there. They don't want you to hide behind closed doors. You've become this hermit where you're not really socializing, you're not really communicating with anybody, and they don't want you to do this. You know, with the judgment, they want you to make a decision and move forward. And also with the judgment as well, they're saying you're judging yourself, you're blaming yourself here, and it isn't your fault. Yeah, look at this, guys. Maybe for some of you this could have been an accident. For some of you, it could have been an illness. Maybe there was an accident here and you blame yourself for that, because we've got the ultimate betrayal here. We've got this was a really, really painful ending for you guys. You know, it was... yeah, very painful ending, which is understandable. But what they're saying to you is that things can only look up now. That pain that has happened, you need to start looking up. You know, that could have been an illness, because the Five of Pentacles is an illness, you know, sickness. Or it could have been an accident. So take what resonates. So I'm going to get a little bit more from this energy here. They're really worried about you, my pile twos. Very, very concerned about you here. What more would you like to tell my pile two? Okay. No, ones. Death again, guys. Look, they do not want you to suffer with this passing here. They want you to get a fire up your backside. I'm sorry, I'm going to say it like that. Get out there, get passionate about life again. Okay, this is what they're saying, and this is constantly what they're saying. Please find that passion for life and get out there and enjoy life. I'm hearing life is too short. So let's get your postcard from them and your spirit guides. So we've got, dear you, do you feel like you need to do all the work and fix everything for everyone, or you might have no value? Maybe you think you need to control everything, or else nothing will be get done. Be healed, be completed, etc. You may think you need to conform to what others expect of you, or choose a course of action to manipulate an outcome, but we don't think that would be a good choice. So it could also be here with this first paragraph, is that if you do have children with this person, you're trying to make things better for them. It could be that with family members, it's like you're putting on this brave face, but sometimes that's not really the way to deal with things. If you want to tell people to bug off, or you want to shout, you should be able to. How about this? Even if it makes you temporarily uncomfortable, do something different. Set that boundary. That's the Knight of Wands here. Delegate responsibility to another. Right, I think you're taking on too much here. Ask for your needs to be met. And when faced with the impossible situation or sticky, enmeshed relationship, repeat this mantra: I didn't cause it, I can't control it, and it's not my job to cure it. There you go. It's not your... You couldn't control it, is what they're saying. And then carry on. Feels good, doesn't it? The best part of everything just seems to work beautifully and honestly in the end. Love you so, so much. Oh, God. So my pile twos, I hope this helped, and I hope it resonated. If you'd like to leave a comment down below about this situation here, I'd love to hear from you. I love hearing from you guys, and take care, okay, and I'll see you soon. Bye. Hey pile three, so if you chose this pile, this is your reading. So let's get your messages first. We've got a postcard from your loved one, so that comes at the end. So let's get your messages. You've got extra cards, pile three. And you know what I picked up with this pile as well? Really stubborn energy. So I don't know whether that resonates for some of you lot, okay? Very stubborn. So this person in the living may have been very stubborn about certain things, you know, may have been, you know, once they got their head set on something, they weren't budging. That's what I got from this energy with pile three. So we've got, we have been together in dreams. I feel healthy and happy. The earth is our school. Don't believe that. We've got, you are a star. Step into the spotlight where you belong. Explore new ventures. Move forward with confidence. We are with you. Then we have Caressa. You are at the end of a cycle in your life. Call upon your angels to comfort you and to guide you to the next step. Happiness awaits you now. Ooh. Aisha, we've got, I think it's Aisha. I love that name. It's a good time to give birth to new ideas and situations in your life. I am watching over you, guiding you and protecting you during these changes. Right, okay. This is positive. Okay. And then we have renewal, which is 20, no, it's not the world, judgment. Renewing the past with compassion and forgiveness, time to head in a new direction, clarity on your life purpose. In your heart, you know what to do. The star. This could even be a parent. I'm going to find out more about, it could even be a grandparent or someone like that. They're pushing you to do something with yourself, and I feel like it's something to do with being a star, you know, like it could be a platform, it can be like, you know, influencer or something like that. You could even be acting. It's something that's going to put you in the spotlight because you now got the star. Okay, so you've got Aquarius energy here as well. We have faith in the future. No, have faith, the future is bright. Dreams come true, positive changes that bring to an end to challenging times. The light is at the end of the tunnel. The sun, wow, my pile threes. A time of great joy and success, brilliant empathies that lead to magical opportunities. Plans that work out perfectly. Gratitude to the divine. The moon, listen to your intuition and pay attention to signs from the divine. Unnecessary worry, let go of your fears. Revelations will make everything clear. I wonder if this is my pile as well. I'm picking up parental energy here. So yeah, this is really good. So this person could have been sick for a while before they passed, and they're telling you that they're healthy and happy now where they are. You may dream about this person a lot, okay? And they're saying the earth is our school, which I totally believe that. I do believe we learn here and then we go off and, you know, we ain't got to learn no more, if you know what I mean? Because life is hard when you think about it. So, yeah, it could be that you've got a platform, something that you've been working on, and things may not have been happening. It may have been slow to happen. And they're saying, do not give up yet. Keep moving with confidence. They're with you, they're supporting you with this, okay? Things are starting to change for you, things are starting to look up for you here. Or it could be that you've had an idea to do something, you know, that would bring you some success and fame here, that you've not really been confident in doing it. All right, tell me more about yourself, please. Who are you? To my pole phrase. Let's find out who this energy is. Tell me about this energy, spirit. Oh, no. Tell me about this energy, please. Seven of Wands. Exactly what I said at the beginning. When I was shuffling the cards, I felt very stubborn energy. Someone that, as soon as they decided that is how it's going to be, or I'm not moving on this matter, or whatever. The Seven of Wands is someone that stands their ground, someone that's stubborn. King of Pentacles, someone that is very stubborn. Yeah, you couldn't budge this person, or when they made up their mind about something, that was this, that was that. So we've got Taurus, Virgo, Capricorn here. which, yeah, I'm wondering if it is my power as well that came through and all. So yeah, the King of Pentacles could have been someone's father, could have been your spouse even, you know, it can be, could have been your husband. And don't forget, these are energies, it can be a female as well. So the King of Pentacles is somebody that is, you know, a business owner, works really hard for their money, they're financially secure, okay, they do very well, they're very grounded, you know, and they are a provider for the family, you know, for their partner, so they like to provide, they're a giver, okay. Tell us a little bit more. Four of Cups in reverse. Wow. So the Four of Cups is upright. It's rejection. It's feeling, you know, abandoned, neglected. You know, feeling like, you know, you're not fulfilled when it comes to... You're not feeling fulfilled, but this person's saying that it may have been in life that, you know, maybe there was things that went on in their life that they didn't really find much fulfillment out of it. But now they're saying where they are is that they're really fulfilled. They don't, you know. And it could, and what I'm getting a message here as well, it could be that this energy is telling you that maybe you've had a few struggles in regards to this thing that you want to do here, and you may have felt rejected, you may have felt, you know, that things weren't going your way, but that I feel like is what they're saying is your insecurities, be a bit more positive. So what would this energy like to tell my pile three? What would you like to tell them? Oh, look, we've got the Star again. You've had the Star twice now, and the World. Things are going to start looking up for you guys, you know. Wow. Things are really going to start looking up for you guys. You're going to be completing a goal. The goal is there. It's in sight, is what this person is saying. Even I'm getting excited. The goal is in sight. It's you've nearly got it, okay? You know, you've got the strength here. You've been working really hard on this, and you've been very strong. Well, you've tried to be strong, but you have the strength to keep going, is what this person in spirit is saying. You know, the Star is all about success, wishes coming true, you know, dreams coming true. It's, you know, miracles that are happening for you. You may think, oh, you know, it's a bit, I don't know, like, where's it coming from? But yeah, you're going to start seeing miracles happen. Wow. So what more would you like to tell my little pile phrase? Ten of Swords, Judgment, and Page, Prince S of Pentacles, and the Three of Pentacles, the Wheel of Fortune. Yeah, look, the wheel's about to turn here. Something you've been working on very hard. It could be that you were working with others, or it could be that you're competing against others. Okay, so there is competition here, but it's about to turn. The table is about to turn in your favor. Okay. So yeah, with the Ten of Swords, it speaks of, hang on, I need to clarify this Ten of Swords, let's just, hang on, tell me about this Ten of Swords, what are you trying to say? Okay, I see what this person's saying. Right, what they're saying here is, in the past you may have dealt with people that were not genuine, not sincere. They may have backstabbed you quite a lot. They may have even nicked your ideas if it's something to do with, you know, platforms and things like that. Okay, so you've dealt with a lot of toxic people here. Now, you've had to let these type of people go from your life with the Eight of Cups. You've had to walk away from it. Or it could have been like an idea that you may have had that was not right for you, and there may be something else that you're not seeing at the moment, is what this person is saying, you know, because there was a card up there about that. You have the Ace of Pentacles, which is a brand new beginning, okay? It's success, a new career, a new job. You know, it's an increase in income as well. Tell me about this devil here. You may need to be a bit careful though, maybe it's what they're saying, that someone could come and try and take this away from you. Ten of Pentacles. Yeah, look, you've got something here that you can, yeah, look, it's justice. No, this is what's happened in the past, okay? This is what's happened to you guys before. This is the type of people that you've had to deal with, toxic people, people that could be controlling, people that steal your ideas, you know, that kind of thing, okay? And that's brought you a lot of pain. But what this energy is telling you here with the Ace of Pentacles and the Ten of Pentacles is this financial success is going to be guaranteed. You've got the Ten of Pentacles. This is building the future for yourself. This is generational wealth. This is going to bring you a lot of financial stability and increase. This is beautiful, guys. And then you have justice on the back. This is justice, basically. Yeah, this is justice. This is a, you know. Yeah, I feel like this is your good karma, because you've had a lot of, you know, maybe karmic debts that you had to pay off. Maybe karmic people were coming in trying to take what's yours. But also, you do still need to protect yourself, is what I'm hearing from this energy as well, from toxic people, from karmics. Because they will try and take away what's yours. You know, anybody would try that. And now we've got Judgment and the Princess of Pentacles. Yeah, this is them saying that you're going to get some kind of clarity here, like a wake-up call of what it is that you should be doing, or what it is that, or the next step that you need to make here. So you've got a plan, and it's a fruitful plan. It's something that is going to bring in security, okay? And there may be people that you may meet along the way that will be dependable and will support you in this. But I feel from this energy here saying that maybe you need to just rely on you, you know, rely on your... can I explain it? Only you can trust yourself, basically. So what more would you like to tell my pile freeze? See, these people, whoever they are, you know, it can be the competition, it can be people that you know hate the fact that you've got this coming towards you. They cannot stand it. And they will try and use anything to take that away from you, okay, with the devil energy here. So just be very careful. Maybe don't tell people what it is that you're planning, you know, be a bit secretive if you have to. There's nothing wrong with that. You are the Queen of Cups. The Queen of Cups is what's that, Cat, Scorpio, Pisces here. This is you, you know, you're an empath, you're a psychic. So it could be even you're doing something that I'm doing right now. You know, you may want to pursue what is the freaking word for us people? We've been doing this for so many years. You know, you may want to develop your psychic abilities. You know, that's the word. Or donut. So yeah, with the Queen of Cups, she is psychic. She is an empath, okay? But the thing with the Queen of Cups, she can get taken advantage of, because you are very loyal. You are very warm and kind, and you will help people. But you need to protect yourself, is what this energy is saying. Don't let people take advantage of you, okay? And use your intuition, because the Queen of Cups is, her intuition is usually spot on. Your intuition is what they're saying is, will guide you. Listen to that. So do you need to say anything else to a pile of threes? Three of Pentacles again. Yeah, you've got some kind of success here. Some kind of reward. I mean, it could be that outsiders will try and help you. You know, you may have to work with some people. But your intuition will guide you there when it comes to working with other people. Listen to that, is what they're saying. Is there anything else you'd like to say to pile threes? Okay, what advice? See what I mean about the stubborn energy here. What advice would you like to give my pile threes? Oh, nearly. What advice would you like to give my pile threes? There we go. Thanking you. Hierophant in reverse. Interesting. Okay. Just what I said. Three of Pentacles came out, okay? There are going to be people that are going to try and butt in and give you advice, okay? But with the Hierophant in reverse, this energy is saying, this person in spirit is saying it's poor advice. It's people that are not competent to, they don't have an understanding of what it is that you're doing. So these people are going to try and put their two pence worth in. They're going to try and butt their nose in where it's not wanted, you know, try and advise you. But what they're saying here is, do not let them do this. Do not, you know, use that intuition. You'll know what's right for you. And because it looks like they're going to try and lead you down the wrong road here. It's not good advice. With the Four of Pentacles, this is about it's all about, you know, fearing change. You know, it's all about security. It's people that, you know, can be misery as well. Let me see why the Four of Pentacles is here. Why is the Four of Pentacles here? That wanted to come out. That was hovering on my thumb. Yeah, this is something you've been desiring for a very long time, okay? Something you really, really want, and you are so passionate about it. This is your passion. It's like your baby, okay? With the Ace of Wands. You have the King of Wands here. I'm wondering about the King of Wands. Tell me about the King of Wands. Can we trust him or her? Tell me about this King of Wands. Yeah, you can. You've got someone in your life. It can be a partner. It can even be a friend, okay? Fire sign, Aries, Leo, Sagittarius, okay? With this King of Wands, this is someone that is very honest and loyal that's in your life, okay? Someone you can trust that will help you fulfill your dreams. And they will help with your success, or they'll celebrate the success with you. But it can be that someone, this is someone that you're connected to romantically, or it can be a business partnership as well, or someone's just that is giving you the encouragement. This is someone you can actually trust, okay? And they can see that you really want this, and you know, you're going after this, and you've been putting in all the hard work when it comes to this passion that you've got. Now, with the High Priestess, this is another psychic card. This is the unknown, things that have not been revealed to you yet. I'm going to clarify you. Mm, know, but this is also with the high priestess, it's saying trust yourself, trust your intuition. And I've been saying that, and this is what this energy here in spirit is saying. You know what, because you guys have a gift, you can rely on your intuition. I don't see any blockages here when it comes to that. So you know what's right for you. Any more words you would like to tell my pal phrase? Yeah, look, you're very focused. You've turned your vision into a reality now. You've gone after what it is that you want. You've manifested what it is that you want. You've used all your tools, you know, your creativity and things like that to achieve what it is that you want. And the nice thing about the Two of Wands is you chose this road and you stuck with it. You know, you did. You made a decision already and you've been staying on that path that it is that you chose for yourself. Look at this. You've got... you know, this could be communication, this could be messages coming at you, you know, quite swiftly. It can be fast moving energy as well, that things are going to start moving very quickly for you. You know, this brand new beginning that you've wanted, this new start, it's starting to happen for you guys, okay, is what this energy and spirit's happening, is saying. So let's get your postcard from this person. So we've got, dearest you, over here there is no mystery for us to unravel, which clarifies that earth school there. As we know intimately how connected we all are, how the web of creation works, and how spirit is in every aspect of life, from the invisible to the visible. But it's important for humans to comprehend and comprehend the complexities of how things actually work, because most important threads in the tapestry don't make sense in the dimension you live in. That said, can you feel the importance of these currents of energy that bring events together in a miraculous way? You can't understand with your mind, but you know, can know with your heart and soul. Trust that even though you don't know how, the what or the why, we do. Surrender to the mystery and have faith in the unseen world. A faith in the unseen world is watching you with loving eyes as spirit weaves your life's mysterious and beautiful tapestry in glorious technicolor. Loving you so much as always. So what I'm getting from this is, it could be that you don't understand if you have a gift here. I mean, half the time I don't bloody understand my gift. I mean, if you actually see what I see sometimes, I don't just do this, I actually hear things, I actually see things, especially when I moved to this house. Yeah, I mean, it was only, it would freak people out, but I don't, sometimes don't feel like it's actually a bad spirit that's in here. I think we have a couple that come in and out of here, but yeah, me and my daughter were sitting downstairs talking, hubby and someone out, and we've just heard this almighty bang from upstairs. So I've gone running upstairs to see what the hell had happened. And my son's chest of drawers, which is like really high up, heavy, literally got thrown on its face. My daughter's freaking out and I'm laughing. But yeah, I have a lot of weird experiences. So I do believe it's like you question your abilities. Sometimes I question my abilities. It's like, what the hell? You may end up, you know, some of you, if you haven't developed your gifts, maybe you need to start developing it a bit more, because I do feel like you guys are very powerful here. You've got the Queen of Cups, you've got the Empress here. I do feel like you guys are really, really powerful. Empaths, psychics, clairvoyants, clairaudience, you know, go on and on and on. So, yeah, and I feel like you just don't understand it sometimes, and you try and look for these answers, but, you know, I don't think anybody has the answer really, unless you're on the other side. So just enjoy it, is what they're saying. So my pile three, that's me babbling enough. If this resonated for you, please leave a comment, hit like. I'd love to hear from you guys. And you take care and you have a lovely Monday. Bye.